It may be a little inconvenient if you're ever caught out without an umbrella, but the importance of rain to our planet cannot be overstated. It's the key water source for life on Earth. But what would happen if it turned against us? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if rain were dangerous?
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more fascinating content?
For today's question, we're mostly thinking alternate reality and sci-fi dystopia, but there are already many circumstances where rain really is dangerous. If huge quantities come down too heavily, we get flash floods, where rivers burst their banks and the surrounding ground can't absorb the water fast enough, often leaving people and animals with very little time to escape. Large enough storms can then level whole towns and cities very quickly, destroying buildings and also creating frightening, potentially fatal mudslides. This recipe for disaster has claimed thousands of lives across history and displaced thousands more people from their homes. We also have acid rain to contend with in the real world. Although in more recent times we've learned how to predict it and prevent it, all rainwater is slightly acidic. But to be acid rain, it generally has to have a pH value of less than 5.5. Acid rain is created naturally by large volcanic eruptions that eject sulfur into the atmosphere, contaminating the clouds, then the rain, and eventually anything that gets rained on. But we now also know that humans can inadvertently cause acid rain too, by burning fossil fuels and driving gas-powered cars. It's another unwanted byproduct of human-led pollution, although one which can be limited with the right laws in place. But thankfully, there's no rain on Earth that's currently dangerous all the time by its very nature. If this was the case, however, what exactly would the danger be? Well, studies do suggest that diseases can actually be spread through rainfall. The troposphere is a specific layer of the atmosphere, and it's been found to contain lots of bacteria, some of which really could be harmful to humans. We also know that bacteria and viruses can be spread through water, through sea spray, for example. The idea is then that were dangerous bacteria to be transported via rain, taken from the atmosphere above our heads and deposited as droplets onto our heads, that we'd have a major problem to deal with. The good news is that, in the real world, the bacteria in the troposphere is a natural part of the Earth's ecosystem. It helps to keep our planet working as it does, and it isn't something we need to worry about. But there are also some incredibly dangerous waterborne diseases we know of on the ground, including cholera, which has fueled many of history's deadliest epidemics, with the World Health Organization estimating that it kills up to 143,000 people every year. In an alternate world where rain could become contaminated, then perhaps it would be cholera or a bacterium like it that would be spreading through the clouds. And because all the water sources are connected to each other through the water cycle, even clean water supplies would soon inevitably be contaminated too. Lace rain with disease, and that disease could very quickly spread across continents and all around the world. Were such a process ever to be weaponized, and there have been military experiments with cloud seeding in the past, then whoever wielded that weapon could wage war on a truly massive scale. On the bright side, we do at least know how to beat cholera and many other waterborne diseases, mainly by building the right infrastructure to treat and deliver clean water and administering medicines, with a vaccine for cholera in particular. If we had these preventative measures in place for whatever disease today's hypothetical rain was carrying, then it needn't be a global death sentence, even if protecting ourselves against water from the sky would be a 24/7 logistical headache. But that's as far as the bright side goes. If we were instead facing a deadly or unknown pathogen raining down upon us with a high mortality rate, no medicine or treatment, and it was something that could be spread to humans just through skin contact, it would be an entirely different story. If this was the case, going outside during a rainstorm, or even going outside period, would amount to risking death. Even without rain actually falling, there would be a certain degree of danger, seeing as air generally contains lots of moisture. But whenever the heavens truly opened, the sound of rain on a roof would feel like the drums of doom. In this world, human cities would need to function more like space colonies, completely closed off from the outside for our own protection. We'd need rain shelters built over existing cities and towns, leveling every cityscape under universal dome-like structures. New cities would likely be much smaller, or at least a lot shorter, with multi-story skyscrapers becoming a thing of the past on account of it being too difficult to cover them up. One plus side is that we do already design and build our homes so that they shut out the weather and the elements, so nothing would change there. But high-rise penthouse suites wouldn't be all that desirable anymore. Instead, they'd probably be replaced with sky homes hanging off the inside of any given city's protective dome. And whenever any home sprung a leak, it would be more than just a nuisance. But this wouldn't just mean changes to how we built our homes, but also where we built them. Human settlements have historically been based near important water sources, like lakes and rivers. But if the rain was toxic, then all other natural bodies of water would naturally be toxic as well. This would mean that it could actually be better for us to flock to the driest and traditionally most inhospitable parts of the Earth, like deserts, to give ourselves the best chance. One of the driest places on the planet is the Atacama Desert in Chile, South America, with some parts of it thought to have not seen a significant rainfall for at least 400 years. So while moving to an arid place like this may not completely solve the issue of all water sources being tainted, because there are still rivers and pools there, it would at least mean that just going outside wouldn't be such a risk. But of course, there are many reasons why people don't generally live in deserts. They're incredibly testing environments. And even if we did all up sticks and move to the sand, we'd still all be human beings. And we'd still all need water to survive. So what would your options be? In terms of an alternate, potentially safer water source, there's always Antarctica. Yes, it's wildly inhospitable and considered by some to be the closest thing on Earth to conditions on the surface of Mars, but Antarctica's dry valleys are also so arid that they have almost no ice cover. And in this world, no fresh ice is no bad thing. Antarctica has other benefits too. Parts of the continent see almost nothing by way of fresh snow. And the air is so cold that it contains very little moisture, meaning that it would take a long time for contaminated air and rain to reach it. All of which means that we could potentially mine and thaw out Antarctic ice from below the surface to tap a relatively clean water supply, maybe even one that's safe to drink without treatment. It's also fairly hard to imagine the entire population of Earth just relocating to Antarctica, though. It's a mass migration that could probably never happen. So we'd surely favor building our large, climate-controlled, rain-repelling biome somewhere else, anywhere else less extreme. The key then would lay with how effectively we could collect the toxic rain and treat and purify it into something that's usable. Do that, and humanity might have a future across much of the world map. Fail to do that, and our days would certainly be numbered. As such, those on the front line of water treatment would have an extremely hazardous but extremely crucial job, as just a single drop of water on anybody's skin, in their eyes, in their mouths, or up to their noses would mean death. Working with water in any capacity would require specialist training and nerves of steel. But until we learned how to handle and use the rain for our advantage, we could never hope to survive. With whole industries like food, agriculture, healthcare, and anything requiring any amount of time outside becoming impossible, we'd obviously see water shortages, but also crop shortages, and ultimately, millions if not billions of people would die. If something as fundamental to life on Earth like rain and the water cycle was ever to turn against us, there really would be precious little we could do to save ourselves. Because that's what would happen if rain were dangerous.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.